TV footage that we have. Are you planning to use the LGU who invited Direk Jade and his friends to come into the province to stand as witnesses for them?
I wouldn't want to talk about the particular items of evidence that we would be presenting, but what I can say is that we are presently gathering as much evidence as we can, and we believe that there is a lot of evidence that will show that they were not involved at all. In fact, it's a very curious case, because you have Jade and his companions going to Quezon to enjoy, actually as tourists, to enjoy what is being offered there. And then suddenly they are involved in an arson case, and then they go back to the town where they were. And you have as well the CCTV footage. So there's really a lot of questions, I think, in this case that must be answered. And we're ready to do that in a court of law.
The prosecution, Attorney Chell, is saying that they found motive with Direk Jade opposing the Jeepney Modernization Program. That's why they say that there's probable cause for the case to progress further. What of the other three? And from your end, do you think that there is any substantial evidence for the prosecutor to say so?
Motive really is not enough, and there has to be evidence of actual involvement. Many people in our country have expressed concern about the Jeepney Modernization Program. Does that mean that all of us are also suspect when a crime like this occurs? I don't think that our opinions, which is really part of our freedom of expression, can be used against us in this way. What we really need, what law enforcement needs, and I think what will be looked for in court, is evidence, actual concrete evidence of participation. And so far we're ready, as I mentioned earlier, to do battle in court.
I'm curious, Attorney Chell, of the owners of this, of the burned e-jeepney, how do they want to proceed with the case? Has their party been able to speak with your side?
No, to the best of my own knowledge, we've had no communication with them.
All right, and finally, of the many cases of mistaken identity, Attorney Chell, why do you think we should be following this particular case of Direk Jade?
Because it could happen to any one of us. We go around, you end up going in one place that's quite remote. Perhaps next thing you know, you're the subject of, you're a person of interest. Next thing you know, you're being arrested under circumstances that to us are highly questionable.
And finally, sorry, I'd like to get your idea on this one more, because of this case of Direk Jade, there has been talks among our lawmakers to come up with a bill on mistaken identity. What do you think is, I'd like to get your thoughts on this, please.
Well, I think what we really need to look at are the policies and procedures of law enforcers when they conduct warrantless arrests. We all know that the law provides that, as a general rule, warrants must be secured and only judges can issue them. When we allow our law enforcers to take it upon themselves to take away our liberty, I think that must be very strictly construed, and they must be trained in a way that they always respect the rights of ordinary people, people like Jade and his companions.
All right, with that, I will let you go. Thank you so much for your time, taking the time off this weekend, Attorney Chell, to speak with us. You have a good afternoon ahead of you.
Welcome. Thank you.